Today the topic of discussion is salivary gland tumors. Okay, so we are going to discuss salivary gland tumors. Okay, so first we go to the etiology of salivary gland tumor. These are the etiology. Just a minute, I'll check. Okay, fine. So these are the etiology of salivary gland tumor. So radiotherapy to head and neck is for mucoepidermal carcinoma. So there are different type of salivary gland tumors like pleomorphic adenoma. I guess you have heard of pleomorphic adenoma. Then aapka Warthin tumor hai. Then acinic cell carcinoma. So similarly, there is mucoepidermoid carcinoma. Okay. So mucoepidermoid carcinoma ka इटियोलॉजी क्या है? रेडियोथेरेपी टू हेड एंड नेक. ओके, रेडिएशन टू हेड एंड नेक कॉजेस म्यूकोएपिडर्मोइड कार्सिनोमा. ओके, सो दिस वाज द फर्स्ट इटियोलॉजी. देन लेट्स गो टू द नेक्स्ट. एब्स्टाइन-बार वायरस इन्फेक्शन फॉर लिम्फो एपिथेलियल कार्सिनोमा. सो दिस इज द सेकेंड टाइप, lymphoepithelial. Please note down, these are high yield questions. This comes in your exam. Lymphoepithelial carcinoma ka hai Epstein-Barr virus infection. Okay, so lymphoepithelial carcinoma is caused by Epstein-Barr virus infection. Exposure to silica dust and nitrosamine. So this is also one of the reason of salivary gland tumor, exposure to silica dust. Silica ka where we have we heard about tumor related to silica dust? Asbestosis, a disease related to silica dust is asbestosis. Okay, we study it in respiratory pathology or respiratory medicine. Okay, it's not a malignancy but a disease caused by silica. So exposure to silica dust and nitrosamines, then increase this salivary gland tumors have increased risk in females with early menarche and nulliparity. Anyone knows what is nulliparity? Anyone? Menarche, I guess you must be knowing, right? Nulliparity I'll talk in our next slide. Okay, so other reason for salivary gland tumor, we have got trisomy 5 in primary mucoepidermoid carcinoma of minor salivary gland. So trisomy of number 5 chromosome causes mucoepidermoid carcinoma. Okay, then polysomy of 3 and 17 chromosome in adenoid cystoid carcinoma. So this is also another variant of carcinoma, of another variant of tumor of salivary gland, adenoid cystic carcinoma. Okay, translocation involving chromosome 11 in mucoepidermoid carcinoma. So translocation of chromosome 11 also causes a carcinoma, that is mucoepidermoid carcinoma. Nulliparity. What is nulliparity? A medical term used to refer to a condition or state in which a woman has never given birth to a child or has never carried a pregnancy. So nulliparity means a woman who has never given birth to a child or has never been pregnant. Okay, so this is nulliparity. Okay, so most common neoplasm of some this questions, what they say, high yield question, this comes in your exam, NEET MDS और एनी अदर एग्जाम, INICT, ये सब आता है. तो मोस्ट कॉमन न्यूप्लाज्म, दिस हैज कम टू टाइम्स, 2018 को भी आया है और 2019 को भी आया है. मोस्ट कॉमन न्यूप्लाज्म ऑफ सलाइवरी ग्लैंड, दैट इज प्लियोमॉर्फिक एडिनोमा. ओके, मोस्ट कॉमन मेलिग्नेंट ट्यूमर ऑफ सलाइवरी ग्लैंड. सो मेलिग्नेंट, एम फॉर मेलिग्नेंट, एम फॉर म्यूकोएपिडर्मोइड. ओके, एम फॉर मेलिग्नेंट, एम फॉर म्यूकोएपिडर्मोइड. Most common neoplasm of salivary gland in children. Okay, most common neoplasm of salivary gland in children is hemangioma. Okay, most common malignant tumor of salivary gland malignant tumor in children, malignant tumor in children is also mucoepidermoid carcinoma. Okay, most common malignant tumor of minor salivary gland. So there are major salivary glands and there are minor salivary glands. So minor salivary glands ka kya hai? Adenoid cystic carcinoma. Okay. So minor salivary gland most common kya hai? Adenoid cystic carcinoma. Okay. So let's talk about the anatomy of salivary glands a bit. Parotid gland, major salivary glands. Salivary glands are classified as major salivary glands and minor salivary glands. So parotid glands contain serous acini. Okay, what is serous acini? We'll talk in our later slides. And submandibular gland contains serous plus mucinous. So how to remember? Submandibular has S and it also has M. So serous plus mucinae. Okay. And sublingual is smaller. So it contains only mucinous, minor mucinous. Someone, you can mute your audio, everyone. Some noise is coming. Okay. So salivary glands are made up of secretory acini. Acini means a round secretory unit. Okay. So these are acini. Okay. Round secretory unit. Okay. And ducts. There are two types of secretion, serous and mucus. The acini can be either serous, mucus, or a mixture. So acini can be serous, mucus, or mixture. Okay. A serous acini secretes protein in an isotonic watery fluid. A mucus acini secretes mucin. Okay. So mucus acini secrete mucin and serous acini secretes proteins in an isotonic water fluid. Okay, so in mixed serous, both the serous as well as the mucus is produced. Okay, so best diagnostic modality for parotid swelling. So what is the diagnosis we use? We used FNAC. If you have not heard what is FNAC, it is fine needle aspiration cytology. Okay. So open incisional biopsy is contraindicated due to tumor cell implantation and formation of parotid fistula. So incisional biopsy, we don't do incisional biopsy. Why? There are chances of tumor cell implantation and parotid fistula. I guess you must be knowing fistula. What is it? It is an open passage, like yaha se yaha open hai. You must have seen a fistula in children's, if you are posted, you are an intern posted in pedo or in any department or OMR pe bhi dikhai deta hai. Some fistula is there. Yaha se jo chhed ho gaya hai, okay, due to the abscess, this there is some hole in the cheek. So fistula means a one and one open connection. Okay, there is an open connection. Okay, best indication for salivary gland neoplasm, that is MRI. Okay. So ducts of various glands. So what are the ducts of the various salivary glands? Parotid duct is known as Stenson's duct. I guess you must be knowing from your first year anatomy that parotid duct is known as Stenson's duct. Okay, this is important. And where does it open? It opens at upper second molar. Okay, then submandibular gland has Wharton's duct. Okay, it opens at papilla just lateral to frenulum. Okay, so it opens at papilla. I wanted to give a picture for this, but in a hurry I left out this one. Okay, in our next class I'll show you the picture for this. Where does the submandibular gland open? Okay, sublingual gland has duct of Ravina's and Bartholin's duct. So these three all are important questions. Okay, you need to remember. Minor salivary glands are 750 in number, approximately 750 in number. Okay, minor salivary gland. Location of minor salivary gland. Where are the minor salivary gland are located? So it is located in the lip, in the buccal mucosa, retromalar area, and heart palate. Okay. So all salivary tumors are more common in parotid. So most of the salivary gland tumor. Most of the salivary gland tumor common in parotid, okay, except adenoid cystic carcinoma. It is common in minor salivary glands. So please note down this point, this is important. Adenoid cystic carcinoma is common in minor salivary gland, and squamous cell carcinoma is common in submandibular gland. Okay, parotid, what are the types of salivary gland tumors in the parotid? So pleomorphic occurs in parotid, Warthin in parotid, eosinophilic cell carcinoma in parotid, mucoepidermoid carcinoma in parotid, lymphoma and metastatic carcinoma, all of them occurs in parotid. So most common site of minor salivary gland are oral cavity, heart palate. So minor salivary gland are found in heart palate. Okay, minor salivary gland are found in heart palate. Okay, there are no minor salivary glands in the interior half of the palate. So tumor arises on the posterior lateral heart palate and all of the soft palate. So tumors arise in the posterior lateral, okay, heart palate. Posterior lateral means if this is the heart palate, okay, posterior, this is posterior and this is lateral. So this side, this the tumors appear, okay, and all of the soft palate, and soft palate everything is included. Okay, malignancy varies inversely with the size of the gland. Most of the minor salivary gland tumors are malignant. So kya hai jo minor salivary gland tumors hai, minor salivary gland tumors, they are malignant. Okay, whereas this major salivary gland zyadatar benign hote hai. So parotid gland 25%, only 25% parotid gland is a major salivary gland, and only 25% is malignant. Okay, submandibular and sublingual gland 50% malignant. Okay, minor salivary gland 75% malignant. So please note it down. Okay, this three. So open surgical biopsy is contraindicated as it can cause tumor seeding of the tract. Okay, so this is the reason tumor can zyada aur ho sakta hai tumor. Okay, so open surgical biopsy is contraindicated. Most salivary gland tumor are radio resistant. Okay, so radio resistant, we have studied in radiology ki radio resistant kya hota hai. Okay, so it does not work to radiotherapy. Neutron therapy has been used in the management of unresectable salivary gland tumor. So ek neutron therapy hai, so where we cannot manage this salivary gland tumor even with resection. Resection means to cut down. Even if you cannot manage with resection, then what do we use? Neutron therapy. Name of the incision for parotidectomy: cistrunk incision. So what is the name of the incision? This has to be remembered. Okay, for parotidectomy, okay, if you want to remove parotid gland, parotidectomy means removal of parotid gland. So what is the name of the incision? Which incision dena padega? I'll show you a picture of cistrunk later. Okay, in our next class, cistrunk operation. In a hurry I missed out so many things. Okay, cistrunk. Actually, I prepared the slide before, but I was extremely tired. I had a meeting at 2 o'clock, and then after that meeting I was really tired, because we cannot be in front of the laptop all the time. So there is some due to some radiation, there is always some problem. So I was in front of the laptop for a very long time, and then I was very tired, so I needed some rest, and that's why I went to sleep. Now we will talk about pleomorphic adenoma. Okay, so first we'll talk about pleomorphic adenoma. It is a benign salivary gland tumor and most common tumor of major salivary gland. So these 2 points you have to remember. It is a benign salivary gland tumor. Okay, benign salivary gland tumor, and it is the most common tumor of major salivary glands. Okay, so please note down, this question has come repeatedly for 2 years, 2018 and 2019. Most common size is parotid tail. Okay, so parotid ka tail mein zyada hota hai ye. Parotid tail. So one of the portion of the parotid is known as parotid tail. We will discuss in anatomy the different structures, different anatomy of the parotid gland. So parotid tail is a portion of parotid gland, and this pleomorphic adenoma is more common in the parotid tail, less common in the submandibular gland and sublingual glands, relatively rare in minor salivary gland. So pleomorphic adenoma occurs in submandibular also, in sublingual also, but it is more common in parotid, okay, and it is rare in minor salivary gland, more common in female. So female, all of the salivary gland tumor are more common in female, and this salivary gland tumor pleomorphic adenoma occurs in the fourth decade. Wardeen tumor is more common in male. So Wardeen, you remember W ka opposite M hota hai. So it is more common in males, okay? Wardeen males. Okay? So this is pleomorphic adenoma. You can see this person has got pleomorphic adenoma. This is the pleomorphic adenoma, okay? So known as, it is also known as mixed tumor. So pleomorphic adenoma is known as mixed tumor because it has both the epithelial component and the mesenchymal component, okay? That's why it is known as mixed tumor. It has epithelial component and mesenchymal component also. It is encapsulated but sends pseudopodia. Pseudopodia or what? Finger-like projection. So this pleomorphic adenoma sends pseudopodia into surrounding glands. Enucleation is not done to avoid recurrence. So due to this pseudopodia, enucleation is not done to avoid recurrence. Nahi to kya hota hai? Recurrence ho jata hai. Okay. Tumor is located in front, below and behind ear lobe. So tumor is, this is the ear lobe. So it is present in front of ear lobe, behind the ear lobe and below ear lobe. Okay. So this is the ear lobe. Okay. This is present in front, below and behind the ear lobe. Okay. Please remember this. It has very slow growth. Okay. The pleomorphic adenoma has got very slow growth. It is known as dumbbell tumor as it moves posterior pillars. Matlab jo hamara palatal region hai, soft palatal region hai. Okay. And tonsils towards midline. Okay. Have two components, one in oral cavity and one in neck. So jo pleomorphic adenoma hai, it has two components. Okay. One in oral cavity and one in neck. Okay. So that's why it is known as dumbbell tumor. Whichever tumor has two components, like in case of pleomorphic adenoma, it has got in oral cavity and in neck. So that's why it is known as dumbbell tumor. Okay. Pleomorphic adenoma is unicentric, but recurrence are multicentric. So generally the pleomorphic adenoma is unicentric. Okay. But if it reoccurs, then it is multicentric. Okay. Usually does not involve the facial nerve. This is to be remembered. Usually does not involve the facial nerve. Okay. Clinical features, presents as painless swelling. You remember this? Painless swelling. Painless swelling. With typical cited below, and this I told, slow growing lobular woman around 40 years. I told this one. Involving may push the tonsil and pillar of towards midline and also known as dumbbell tumor. This also I told, dumbbell tumor. Why it is known as dumbbell tumor? Because it has two component, oral component and a component towards the neck. Okay. Now diagnosis. Diagnosis, FNAC is used for diagnosis. Again, those who are not knowing, we will altogether have a class on FNAC. Okay. For the third year oral pathology, we'll have a class on FNAC, where we'll discuss FNAC in detail. So for the time being, you know it, that it is fine needle aspiration cytology. Okay. So treatment is superficial parotidectomy. This is also known as Pettus operation. Excision of whole gland in case of pleomorphic adenoma or submandibular gland. So if the pleomorphic adenoma is of submandibular gland, we do excision. Okay. Fine. Now, what are the complications? What are the complications we can see with pleomorphic adenoma? So, malignant change, that is 3 to 5% of the pleomorphic adenoma changes into malignancy. Okay, so that malignancy is known as carcinoma ex pleomorphic adenoma or malignant mixed tumor. You remember this name, carcinoma ex pleomorphic adenoma. Okay. Or it is known as malignant mixed tumor. Okay, so this has rapid growth, this malignancy, you can see pain. Otherwise pleomorphic adenoma is painless, but in malignancy it has pain. Paresthesia can be seen, enlarged cervical lymph node, restriction of jaw movement, facial weakness, and fixation of mastoid tip is suggestive of malignant transformation. So these are the features, not very important. You remember just it is painful. And you remember the name carcinoma ex pleomorphic adenoma. It might be asked in your viva. Okay. So histological finding suggestive of malignant changes, necrosis, hemorrhage. This is not very important. Okay. Recurrence is common after, particularly after enucleation. If enucleation is done, then recurrence may occur. Okay. So indication of radiotherapy. Where, in which type of tumors we can give radiotherapy. Okay. So we know that due to radiotherapy, this mucoepidermoid carcinoma occurs. But there are other tumors where we can give radiotherapy. So in high-grade tumors, we can give radiotherapy. Large primary lesions, we can give perineural invasion. There is a specific salivary gland tumor where perineural, matlab nerve is involved. We'll talk about it later. Nerve is involved. Okay. Then bone invasion, where there is bone involved, cervical lymph node metastasis and positive surgery. So these are all questions of previous years. Okay, I have written Q over, above everyone. So please note down this one and study this thing. Okay, so now we will talk about Warthin's tumor. Okay, Warthin tumors is also known as papillary cystadenoma lymphomatosum. So this comes as a question. Which of the tumor is known as papillary or papillary Warthin tumor ka other naam kya hai? It is papillary cystadenoma lymphomatosum. Okay, so it is the second most common benign tumor of the parotid gland. So first kya hai? This pleomorphic. Second is Warthin's tumor. Okay, derived from salivary tissues, inclusion in lymph node. So it is derived from salivary tissues. Okay, salivary tissue inclusion in lymph node. So arise can arise from cervical node. So it arises from lymphomatosum. You can see here. So it arises from lymph nodes. This you have to remember. Okay, it arises from lymph node. Occurs exclusively in parotid gland. So Warthin tumors is seen only in parotid gland. It is seen nowhere. Okay. So you remember, Warthin tumor is always seen only in parotid gland, and it is seen nowhere. Okay, and it always occurs in the lower portion of the parotid. Okay, overlying the angle of mandible. So this is the location of Warthin's tumor. Okay, so this is the bilateral Warthin tumor. Okay, this person has got lower portion of, see what is written, lower portion of parotid overlying the angle of mandible. So it is near the angle, this is the angle of mandible, right? So it is near the angle of mandible, this Warthin tumor. Okay, consists of both epithelial and lymphoid elements. So remember this, epithelial and lymphoid elements. It has got lymphoid element, thus known as adenolymphoma. That's why it is known as adenolymphoma. It is more common in males. So I have shown you the picture. It is more common in males and in 5 to 7 decades. So this person is an old man. So he is in, you can guess the age from 5 to 7 decade. Okay, so associated with smoking. So it is associated with smoking, bilateral in 10% cases. I showed you the picture. This bilateral never involves facial nerve. So facial nerve is never involved. In case of parotid gland also, facial nerve is not involved. There is one specific salivary gland tumor which involves the nerve, trigeminal nerve and the facial nerve, that I will talk later. Okay, it is well encapsulated, cystic, extremely slow going, never turns malignant. So it never, it is totally benign. Okay. Peculiar feature of Wardian tumor hotspot in 99 m TechNet scan. So this has to be remembered. Hotspot. I'll talk about this hotspot in hotspot and cold spot in thyroid tumors. When we'll talk about the tumors of thyroid, we'll talk about hotspot. Hotspot are like black spots you can see in this technetium peritechneal scan. Okay, so that we will discuss later. So only Wardian tumor. This has come as a question. I think the year before previous year, it has come as a question. Okay, in NEET MDS. Okay, so this shows hotspot. Okay, Wardian tumor and other all other tumors show cold spot. So please remember this one. This is important. So histopathology. Papillary cystic pattern lined with columnar oncocyte and cuboidal cells marked with lymphoid component. So columnar oncocytes are there. Above that, cuboidal, these things are there, cells are there, okay? Lined by double layer of neoplastic cell, okay? So double layer, as I have shown you here, double layer of neoplastic cells are there, okay? The double layer of lining cells are distinctive with a surface palisade of columnar cell resting on a level layer of, so cuboidal cell is below, I guess. Cuboidal cell is below, and above that there are columnar cells. Okay, so this is double layer. Please note it down. Okay, diagnosis, FNAC is the best diagnostics modality. Treatment, we use superficial parotidectomy. So next is mucoepidermoid carcinoma. We will discuss in 2 minutes. I will be sending you another link. And we'll finish this class. We have got less than 1 minute to finish, so we won't be able to finish. I'm sharing you the link in your group, so please go back to your group and join through the link. Okay, and today at 8 o'clock, I think 8:30 will be better today. So 8:30 we'll be having MCQ discussion related to salivary gland tumors. Okay, and I'll try to include whatever I have not included here, like ranula has not been included, some submandibular salivary glands have not salivary gland tumors have not been included here. So I'll include those.